Welcome to Zapp Brannigan's Spaceship of Love 3, Return of the Brannigan. Many of you are returning from previous year's shows, but for those of you who are new here, I shall explain the procedure of the panel. Spaceship of Love is an in-character panel, where members chosen randomly from the audience will be brought up on stage and given a mock job interview with the esteemed Zapp Brannigan. One of the highly prestigious positions on the legendary warship, the Nimbus. Contestants will be given positions on the ship at the end of the show, following a special closing game among all contestants. So be sure to stay until the very end. There are a couple things we need to keep in mind, however. A list of rules to keep the show going or getting too chaotic. Our designated rule giver, Axel, will now read them off.
Rule number one.
No!
Rule number two, no whining. Rule number three, follow typical Sakura-Con rules. Be safe and don't do stupid crap. Rule number four, this panel is rated PG-13. Keep the language cleanish. No harsh swears, no overly lewd words, nothing too graphic. But use as many double or triple entendres as you want. It's more funny to talk about something inappropriate in a roundabout, subtle way than just to blatantly say it. When in doubt, ask yourself, could they get away with it on Futurama? Rule number five. This is an in-character panel. Try to stay in character as much as you can. And always try to keep in mind that some characters aren't exactly nice people. If something is being said or done that offends you, just remember it was most likely done in jest with no malicious intent behind it. Zapp Brannigan is a lecherous pervert. His eyes may wander, and he'll flirt with anything he thinks is feasible. Don't go getting offended if he calls your girlfriend hot. Rule number six, throw away your inhibitions. Be silly, let loose, have fun.
Yeah! Yeah! Now, no, this is where I would do a big speech.
Return of the Brannigan.
Peter's head
heads up and sit down. We got a special surprise for you. You got that video ready?
Congratulations! You've been successfully recruited to be among the best, the brightest, and the most red-shirtiest of all the armies. Your shirts are so good, in fact, that studies have shown the shirts of the Nimbus crew are 40% redder than the next leading red shirt force. This video will be your crash course on being one of the most well-respected spacemen known to man. Now let's get going and go over what will be expected of you as part of Zapp Brannigan's crew. Part 1, your duties. Now you are probably asking yourself, what are my duties as one of the double crew members of the Nimbus? Don't worry about it. Your superiors will handle all those tough, nasty jokes for you. You just have to sit tight and wait to be called upon. This is a little tactic that we like to call streamlining, which our marketers tell us to use because it makes us seem like we care about our recruits. Some of the duties may include protecting your superiors in times of need. Remember, danger can lurk behind any corner, so you must remain ever vigilant. Other duties will include keeping our state-of-the-art training facilities clean of pets, so that recruits can stay tip-top. Expected to do on a day-to-day basis. Part 2, interactions with the outside world. As a member of Zapp Brannigan's crew, you'll be expected to deal with all sorts of people. Here are just a few that you'll be seeing during your time in service. Let's start with civilians. The civilians are a primitive race of subhumans that wind up, and tend to believe that they have rights, just like the captain. Oh, such a notion is completely ridiculous. Us here at the Nimbus like to be professional in all lines of work. So, be human and pretend to treat them as equals. Here's what to do if you find yourself under the barrage of mindless dribble for civility. Simply pretend to care about their petty problems about eating or being invaded or whatever it is they worry about. And meanwhile, you may actually ponder the true mysteries and problems of the universe. Well, let's see what our would-be recruit here is thinking about right now. Discuss what to do under an emergency situation. Attack! Urges under received. In this portion of the video, we will show you what is expected of you under the extremely lengthy event that Earth comes under attack from alien invaders. Part 4. We here at the Nimbus know that memory can go far. Therefore, we've created this handy acronym to help you remember everything you've learned so far. It stands for Helpful, Adventurous, Never Backs Down, and Dies First. Let's take a look at a couple of theoretical tangents and see what comes up. Looking for some help across the street. But what part of our hand do you use? That's right. We use adventurous. Give a little boot out of the traffic and make your life more interesting. Let's take a look at another theoretical situation. You discover that your roommate is suicidal. Oh no. You find out about this just as he's about to do something drastic. Now once again, what part of the hand do you use? Be hard. Of course you got that right. We covered a lot of ground. With such an expendable part of our enterprising enterprise, we know that you'll catch on quick and fill in those blanks in no time. Happy hunting, and enjoy your time aboard the Nimbus.
Excellent. We're off to a good start already.